All right, this week on Land Beat, we're gonna be talking about strategy and new food plots. So this is a new food plot here on my farm. Couldn't be more excited about it. I have looked across the fence just to the south of us my entire life of this piece that we didn't own and this field that was turning into cedars. Well, in the last 6 months, family has purchased this property and now we're restoring it and making it highly productive habitat for all kinds of wildlife, but it's also got a lot of strategy involved so we can harvest mature bucks right here in the Ozark Mountains. Where I'm standing is site number one for a blind for future hunts. So we're gonna place a blind right here next to this sassafras tree. Great access to the south, slipping in. We're not walking in the food plot. That's one of the biggest errors we make when setting up farms on food plots. If your feet are walking across a food plot, we're already making a mistake. So we're slipping in, never entering the food plot. We're gonna have screen of sedan grass, and then this winter we're gonna plant it in switchgrass. So we're gonna have an annual screen year one, perennial screen year two, right here, the first 10 to 15 yards of this field. So eyeballs are shielded in the food plot, protecting us as we slip into this blind. It's a great blind for gun hunting, but we're gonna set it up to where it's great for bow hunting as well. So as we pan around, you can see this is about a 5-acre field, food plot. It's gonna be soybeans year one. We're gonna turn it into a good buffer strip around it, 20, 30 yards of pollinators, native grasses, so we have a real good soft edge, as well as keeping the center part food plot. You can see lots and lots of potential food produced here. As we look here to the north, we've got a big chunk of timber. We've got a pond, so we've got a great water source. We're gonna have TSI bedding cuts. We've covered bedding cuts on other videos. On showing how to implement those. We're gonna have one just to the northeast of here, a couple hundred yards. Another one to the north, a couple hundred yards. We've got this bottleneck forming with the two draws, the drop in elevation. Deer are working their way with north winds. Bucks are gonna cruise the south side of this timber chunk as they're coming through here to come out to the food plot on the south side. So the wind is in their favor to use their nose as they're scent checking this whole area. So they're gonna work down through here. Huge advantage, you see this big dogwood dropping over in this trail that goes along the edge of the food plot. So we're gonna have mock scrape there, monitoring deer that are coming and going through here. Water hole, bedding cut, TSI'd off of that after the logging operation. So we're checking all the boxes in improving habitat. We're going with TSI timber, temporary forest openings or bedding cuts for strategic bedding place for the deer. We've got a water hole, we've got a food plot, we're gonna have natives here, so we have additional summer forage, mock scrape, and then just past this blind, just out of bow range, we're gonna do hard edge feathering, so we're steering those deer to use this south entrance or the north entrance, not necessarily in the middle of the field. So if deer are frequenting on the north side and we have a target buck, we can slip in with bow, or a tree stand, but a lot of them should be shifting to the south edge to use the wind to their favor. Bedding cuts, TSI, edge feathering, water holes, fruit trees, food plots, pollinators, these are all things you should consider to have successful hunts in your future.